industry and do beauty, what are some of the requirements?
First and foremost, you need passion. Passion is like the major thing, because you can't do something that you don't like. So you have passion, then you should have like patience to deal with different kinds of people, because people out here are really trying. Someone can test your patience and you're like, I don't want to do this anymore. But if you have the passion to do this business, you'll be able to deal with people. Then if you're very artistic, you'll continue like learning more, and you'll be very excited to want to know more and keep up with what's going on. Yeah, that's how you keep up in this business.
And some of the skills that are required in the business, because it's not something that is automatic. Lazima kuna skills fulani you need to acquire so that you can stand out.
Mostly, what happens these days, you keep up with the trends that are happening. Like, you see, the people used to do eyebrows in, that is, say, 2002. It's not the same way we do our eyebrows in 2021. It's different. You keep up with the trends. That way you'll be able to be more marketable, and like whatever you do it very keenly so that you can stand out. Yeah.
So you told me that you're a makeup artist.
Yes.
How did that start? How did that journey start?
Initially, I just loved makeup since I was young. I used to get my eyebrows cut by my mom when I was going to school, and I thought, hey, that was really nice. That was really, you're different from everyone else. You look really nice. Then when I joined campus, I used to do my makeup on a daily basis, even though I didn't know what I was actually doing, but my eyebrows are always on fleek. Then I had like a small eyeshadow. It didn't have much pigment until now. Like, if I compare the knowledge that I had then and now the one that I have, it's totally different. So I just loved makeup. So I thought, if I love doing makeup for myself, why not like do it on other people? Make them feel good about themselves. Yeah.
So you're self-taught, hakuna ati shule yote uliattend?
Sijaienda shule. Ni YouTube.
And that works.
Yeah, it really
so
works.
In front of us we have some things. Maybe you can take us through what they are, what they are used for.
Oh, okay. Here we have the eyeshadow. We have the eyeshadow.
Okay,
majorly here we have the eye makeup. Just talk about the eye makeup. We have the eye pencil, which you use to outline your eyebrows after you already got them shaped. You can't draw them when they are bushy and all, they look so bad. So after you outline your eyebrows with the eye pencil, you choose a concealer that is like a shade brighter than your skin tone, just a shade.
Or brighter?
Yeah, that actually depends if you want your makeup to pop, but you can also use the one that's same as your skin tone for nude makeup. And then after you already done your eyebrows, you can use this brush to blend everything out. And then you can use the eyeshadow to like make the look that you want. Yeah.
And how do you deal with people who have like sensitive skin? Because I know like there are people who have sensitive skin. Do you just use any product, or there's a specific type of brand that you use?
Okay, so for me, I use original products, which is very rare for someone to get a reaction. But those people who use like the counterfeit ones, you're prone to get reactions to your face. Yeah.
And you talked about this industry being tricky because clients are different. So what if you do you make someone's face and they are not pleased with the result? How do you handle that situation?
Now, the first thing you do before you actually pick someone's makeup, you ask them what kind of look are they going for, to avoid erasing everything. So when they tell you they want a bold look, you give them the bold look they asked for. They tell you they want subtle, simple, you give them that. If it's for bride, actually, you already know what you give them, because they don't go for bold looks. You go for bridal, nice looks. Yeah.
So it just depends with what the client wants.
Yeah, you have to ask that before you do the makeup to avoid wasting time reapplying, erasing, and all that. And it's actually very messy.
Okay, and in the makeup industry, in the makeup business, because this is Entrepreneurship Tuesday and we talk about business, would you say it's something that has money and something that you can actually work, like that can be like your work full time?
We can say that it's paying. Yes, it is paying. But it depends, like, on what occasions. Daily makeup is just easy money that you can get every day. But when you get the bridals, the rorashios, you can get good money out of that.
And in a month, how frequent do you get such jobs, like the big events that need you to apply makeup?
Currently, due to corona, there are a lot of restrictions. So mostly, like in my March, I was supposed to like to travel to Nairobi, to Nyeri. I had bookings, but since the lockdown, it was really hard. So some weddings were cancelled, others were postponed. But let's say on a normal setup, like no corona, you can get a wedding like 2 to 3 times a month.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And how are you dealing with the whole corona issue? Because at the end of the day, you need to eat, you need to, you know, provide for your family. So how are you dealing with the corona despite everything that is happening?
It's a bit tricky, but we're able to handle, because you can't lack clients who want like photo shoot makeup, others want baby bump. You can't need luck, yeah.
And maybe you can tell us the pricing of maybe a simple face beat or a complex one. Mm. Do the different types of makeup, you know, prices vary with them? Like, yeah, if I sure. told you I just wanted a simple look, would that mean that the price charged is cheaper than if I wanted something bold and complex?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, if you want something simple, they actually vary. Because if you want something detailed, you'll have to pay more, because obviously you'd want lashes, more contouring, something glamorous. But if you want something subtle, the price is less.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you say that you've been an entrepreneur for 2 years.
Yeah, my third year now.
This is your third year.
Yeah.
So what are some of the lessons that you've learned along the way?
Be patient with yourself. It's not easy. Then you trust God in whatever that you do. Also, something that I've learned that is major, if you can just wait a little and save more money, you don't need to do partnerships, especially if the person you want to partner with is having the same skills as you. But if you have someone you can partner with who does something different, that would be a good idea.
And why is that? Why is it that it's good to partner with someone who has a different skill set than yours?
Because you'll not like fight for clients, competition. Because, for example, if I do a good job, a better job than you, you'd actually feel bad when I get more clients and you don't. Mm-hmm. But if you have another skill set, like if you do dreadlocks or hair, if you have your own clients who you deal with, who you'd sort dreadlocks and that do makeup, so there's no that competition, negative competition.
But regardless of that, the makeup industry is iko na watu wengi. There's so many makeup artists,
yeah,
and
sure.
self-taught actually. So what makes yours, Judy, stand out from anyone else? What is it about your makeup that makes you stand out from everyone else?
First of all, I am a perfectionist.
Okay.
So I can't let you go out of my shop if I'm not satisfied with what I've done. So I'll make sure you look pretty, and I'll make sure you're also satisfied. Yeah.
Mm.
Which most makeup artists don't like keep in regard, because they'll be like, I've done this makeup, and if it's nice to me, it's nice to you too.
Mm.
They don't ensure customer satisfaction,
mm.
which is not right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so you say that apart from makeup, you also own a salon that deals with different things, manicure, pedicure, dreadlocks, braiding.
Yeah.
So how do you manage it? Like, what are some of the management skills that are required in managing a salon and the people that work under you?
Okay, first and foremost, I'm all about growth, individual growth for everyone. So I don't like have employees in my shop. I lease out space, like for the hair person, I lease out space, and the dreadlock person, I lease out space. But for nails, I have one employee, because most times when I'm actually out doing makeup on weddings, I have to leave someone to like hold it up for me. Yes, that's how I don't have a lot of stress while managing my shop. So long as you just pay whatever you're supposed to pay, that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And how do you divide the money between the people who have leased out space? Like how does that work?
There's some certain percentage
mm-hmm.
for the rent. Yeah. You lease out space with certain amount of money. Not a lot, just like it so many, like just a little percent.
Mm.
Yeah.
So if I braided someone's hair, are the money that I got from that client is mm-hmm. mine, but
yeah.
at the end of the month I have to like give you something small
for the rent. Yes.
Okay, so
as far as the agreement.
Mm.
Yeah.
And being an entrepreneur is not easy, because I'm sure like the journey did not start off but in a smooth way. So what are some of the mistakes that you've made in this journey of being an entrepreneur?
First, in this business you don't trust people that easily. You do whatever you feel is good for you, that's what you do. Don't listen, like, don't do that, it won't help you, Nini. Just do whatever you want and you feel like it will help you in the future. Another thing, follow your passion. And if you feel like you want to help other people grow as well, just do it.
Mm. And what are some of the mistakes that you made personally? That you learned
partnership
or you partnered with?
I partnered with someone and it didn't go well. So if I had another choice, like I'd save up more and do it myself. But right now I was patient with myself. I saved up more and I took a loan, but it was helpful
mm-hmm.
because I did whatever I wanted without having to consult anyone.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And how do you increase customer satisfaction in the beauty industry? How do you make a customer stick to you and not look aside?
Mm. As I said, I ensure customer satisfaction is key. You ask them what they want and you deliver whatever they asked for. That is how you ensure that the customer will go back and still come back the other time. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And give referrals to other people.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so far, what are some of the benefits that you've seen in being an entrepreneur than being employed?
You can manage your own money.
Yes.
You can go to work at your own time. You can make your own decisions without consulting anyone. Actually, that's the best part, because no one is controlling you, your own boss. You do whatever you want. You spend your money the way you want, but obviously you have to save. You divide the business money and your salary. Yeah. Mostly it's about decision making. You grow more because you know it all depends on you.
Mm. And for someone who's watching you right now and wants to get into this industry, maybe you can, you know, give them some few words of encouragement.
Okay, it has to come from the heart. It has to be all about the passion. From there you can grow and become a better person. You can actually do whatever you like. You can play around with the art. You can, if you feel like you just want to do whatever, so long as the customer is satisfied.
Okay, talking just about playing around the art, I'm thinking maybe umelala usiku alafu idea imekuja kwa akili. Maybe this face can look like this. Do you try it on yourself or you try it on a client first?
You can't try it on the client.
Okay.
What if it goes wrong?
Okay.
Yeah, you look at it and you think, does it make sense? If it does make sense, you can try it out. There's also the internet, which helps us a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can look at the photos and see if it works with the complexion of your clients.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, and what are some of the risks that are in this business? What are some of the things that are risky?
Mismanagement of funds and miscalculations. Like right now, due to COVID, business is a bit slow because priorities change. You can come to make your nails and you don't have a job. So you look at the way you spend your money. So business can be slow because of certain circumstances that we cannot avoid. So you have to strategize on how to manage your business.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is under the risks that to encounter at the moment, because if business is slow, everything goes slow.
Yeah. Okay, sawa. And maybe as we wind up, maybe you can tell people where to get you, where to get your salon. If you have any social media pages, maybe you can share with guys.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm in Nakuru County. Shoppers Paradise, first floor, room T02. You can visit me there at any time. Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Thank you for joining us. And thank you for sharing with us some of the things that are required in the beauty sector. Okay, so that was Judy Nyambura, and she's an entrepreneur who deals with makeup and also has a salon that deals with braiding and does dreadlocks, manicure and pedicure. And right about now, we're going to go for a short break, but we'll be right back with more interviews. And don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms at Y254 channel.